Okay, so this balance exercise, alright, not only give you a gentle and relaxing workout, it's a series of posture that flow into each movement without pace, without pause, making sure that your body is in constant motion. That means that your body is not overloaded, but while at the same time, it's working hard enough to make sure that it receives the kind of movement that we should be. That means the body, the muscles, and your skeletal are all in harmony with one another. Okay? So, without the movement and the concentration required by Tai Chi, like I said, like I mentioned before, forces want to live in the present moment, putting aside distressing thoughts, and participants are better equipped with the know-how to handle stress more effectively. A lot of people handle stress differently. Some of you are being trained or well-known, hey, how to do. Or some of you, let's say, you start to drinking or smoking, that different form. Like I say, fitness is a choice. Whether what choice that you make, ultimately it is the body that's going to receive. Okay. So I say there's a balance, agility, coordination, and proprioception. Okay, why is it about the coordination? Okay, the vertebra is one of the movements that you need. That is the whole body and hand movement, but it looks simple. Okay, because in the daily, a lot of movement that we don't really activate on the right brain and the left brain. So through all the practice of the Tai Chi movement, it helps to activate or trigger the left and right brain in a way. So we're using action to train. And while the normal convention is to use the left brain to trigger the action. Okay. Alright, so, and Tai Chi is actually one form of functional exercise. Functional exercise nowadays, when we talk about functional exercise, is what you are doing or what you're exercising. Functional to what we are supposed to do. In the daily activity, we need to walk, we need to sit, we need to run, or we need to climb upstairs. So is it functional? If it's not functional, that means that what you do is not going to translate to what you're going to move. So it's like, you are just doing something, but it's not going to, you are not going to use it. Yeah, let's say that in our daily life, virtually every movement we need to do, we are in the three plane, whether you walk front, to the side, or to the front. So the Tai Chi movement is more of the movement, more of the exercise. Let's say in the gym, when you do the gym as a example, you only focus on movement of body in a single plane. It's an isolation. So while it is good, but you don't see a lot of people walking with your bicep, unless when you need to hold on something, or the ladies when they need to hold on, they have that. Okay, so these are the things that the functional program that is required. Like just on the movement that we do, which is called a bow stance. How is it functional? This is actually the activation of the hip or the hip flexor that we do. And this movement mimics the movement that we do for walking. When you need to flex your hip, as you lower down to pick up anything that's on the floor, so that you do not strain on your back, but rather on the movement, and you maintain your centering. Okay, the balancing that you have, so that you minimize the risk of fall. A lot of time, let's say, especially for people with osteoporosis, the risk does not come from the disease, but rather from the fall, of the risk of fall that they have. Because of the fall they have, the risk of fracturing, especially in the hip fracture, is higher. So one way, even with people with certain conditions as osteoporosis, they're able to live a healthy life if they're able to have a good balancing. And that's where Tai Chi comes. And there are actually programs or scientific research that say that Tai Chi actually has benefits for people with osteoporosis. Or going to the toilet or just changing our shirt. Okay. Especially those who have suffered or suffered from injury, let's say frozen shoulder, you all should have a better understand what I'm saying. You can't even lift your arm. And while this range of motion is painful, okay, does it mean that we do not move, but rather we should even stretch it further so that we do not restrict the movements. Okay, so while Tai Chi is a gentle movement, actually it slowly, okay, and effectively increase that range. Okay, so this is actually, so Tai Chi is no longer just for the so-called the oldest. Okay, people from the younger generation, more of teens or actually come and to make it as a more to bring it as a more trendy on the sports, try to promote, and more younger executives actually are going into releasing form because away from that stressful workload, they want something to be more subtle and more. So they are actually looking into this form, the holistic fitness that we just mentioned about. Okay. Alright, and I say that Tai Chi for disease prevention. So what you want to do is a simple physical activity and invention as much to enhance the well-being of individual. Let's say people with diabetes, okay, other than taking medications, the doctor will actually advise, hey, you need to exercise. But what kind of exercise that is more safe, that is more proper? Doesn't mean that the other exercise is no good. But Tai Chi is able to help you in a more subtle and able to improve your whole well-being, and the return to physical exercise, okay, did not be filled with any of injury, especially those who have not been exercising for a long time. Suddenly you feel, hey, I want to exercise. So suddenly for the next 2 weeks, you jog 3 times a week, you swim 2 times a week. After that, you find, hey, your whole body is aching. You got previously the injury that you do not have done. You find, hey, your knee is pain, your heel is pain. So you find, hey, all this comes to you. Then, hey, is it good or bad? They used to say, no pain, no gain, correct? Okay, now it's no longer the case because the recent study is if there's any pain, you have little gain. So we need to listen to our body. So what you want to do is, instead of relying on medication to relieve, let's say, pain in the joints, there are actually tips on providing a restoring function as much as possible, okay, with sensory graded and controlled Tai Chi exercise. Without aggravating the old joint or back injuries, nor creating new ones. That means that today, whichever level that you are at now, okay, the ideal situation is to maintain or improve and not to go to a lower level. So it's not about creating stress on the body, but rather to enable the body to take up new stress and take up new challenges so that the body, okay, become younger. Is it possible? Okay, there are two different age that we talk about. What is your chronological age? Which is how many years from the point that, from the day that you are born. This age number, we can't change. But this point is called the biological age, that how the body functions. And you'll be more surprised that a lot of people are biologically older than their chronological age. Especially when you talk about people with degeneration neck. The neck can be 5 years older than the whole body. And all these things will just go along the way if you do not do anything to prevent or to act on it. And rather than just relying on medication alone. But I say that medication is a need if you it is prescribed by the medical doctor. But you can use exercise to help and lessen on that impact. And from there, you can learn to manage and live happily or live well from there. Alright, so this is just one of them.